Welcome to St. Mary's School online classes. Welcome to the English session of class 6. Students, see page number 23 of your English textbook. Lesson number 4, Reaching for the Moon. Now, let's start with the lesson. Dr. Indira Nair was part of the team that developed some of the instrument for India's mission to the moon, Chandrayaan 2. She is visiting the school where she studied as a child. She will have an interactive session with the student. The students are extremely excited about Dr. Nair's visit and are curious about India's space program. Mrs. Asha Vakil, the science teacher, is holding a discussion with the class. Character: science teacher Mrs. Asha Vakil. Students of class 6C: Anuj, Kiran, Veronica, Sohail, Harpreet, Karthik, Jayant, Sarah, Ellen, Natasha and Ritesh. A class in progress. Anuj: Ma'am, is Dr. Nair a space scientist? Kiran: What's the difference between a space scientist and an astronaut? Veronica: Ma'am, who were the first Indian scientist to explore space? Mrs. Vakil, laughing: I know you have many questions, but please take turns to ask the questions. Sohail: What do you wish to say? Sohail: I know the answer to Kiran's question. A space scientist studies space and builds spacecraft. An astronaut travels into space in a spacecraft. Mrs. Vakil: That's right. Many astronauts are also trained scientists, and sometimes they conduct experiments in space. And Veronica, to answer your question, Vikram Sarabhai and Homi Bhabha were the first Indians to work on a space program. Harpreet: I remember reading about it. They were the first to conduct experiments related to the Earth's upper atmosphere and cosmic rays. Mrs. Vakil: That's right. Now, what do you know about the moon? Veronica: On the moon, we weigh 1/6 of our weight on the Earth. Anuj: This is because the gravity of the moon is not as strong as that of the Earth. Harpreet: We also know that the moon's gravity causes tides in the seas and oceans. Kiran: I had read that the moon has a very thin atmosphere. It is almost a vacuum, so the sky appears black on the moon. Mrs. Vakil: Yes, and that is why no sound can be heard on the moon, because sound waves need a medium like air or water to travel. You will learn about this soon. Karthik: But why do we explore space and send satellite into it? Mrs. Vakil: Space technology helps a country solve many of its everyday problems. For instance, the satellites we have in space are used to forecast weather condition. We can now predict storms and cyclones much in advance and save people's life. For instance, in May 2020, we could rescue lakhs of people before Cyclone Amphan hit our shores. We can use space technology to map our land and water resources. It is also used for electronic communication. Jayant, has India sent any humans into space yet? Sara, I know the answer. India has plans to do this by December 2021. I saw this on the news. The spacecraft will be called Gaganyaan. Ellen, but what about Rakesh Sharma? Wasn't he an Indian who went into space? Mrs. Vakil, yes, Rakesh Sharma did go into space, but it was a part of a joint project between the Indian Air Force and the Soviet Intercommerce space program. We have also had astronauts of Indian origin such as Kalpana Chawla and Sunita Williams. Natasha, did any of them land on the moon? Mrs. Vakil, no, Natasha, they did not. They just went into space. Only 12 people have ever walked on the moon, and they were all NASA astronauts. Who remember the name of the first person to have set foot on the moon? The class in chorus, Neil Armstrong, Mrs. Vakil, and the second, Sarah, Buzz Aldrin. Ma'am, we already know so much about the moon. Other countries have been to the moon and into space. Why did we do the same thing with Chandrayaan 1 and Chandrayaan 2? And why did not India send astronauts on this mission? Mrs. Vakil, well, it is not very easy or cheap to build system for that, Sarah. Also, with Chandrayaan 1, our goals was different. We wanted to survey the moon. Chandrayaan 1 made more than 3,400 orbits around the moon and sent back about 70,000 lunar images. Ellen, I have seen many of those pictures. Some of them are very clear and detailed. Ritesh, but if we had already done this with Chandrayaan 1, why did we send Chandrayaan 2? Mrs. Vakil, you see, Chandrayaan 2 had very special goal. It was to study the soil on the surface of the moon near its south pole. This has not been done till now. The craters there are extremely cold and everything is frozen. So, fossils found on these craters can tell us about the early solar system. Veronica, like how life began on the Earth. Mrs. Vakil, yes, the moon is the closest link to the Earth's history. Its surface, especially the South Pole, is completely undisturbed, so we might find things that tells us a lot about the early life of our planet. Veronica, wow. Mrs. Vakil, it is fascinating, isn't it? But save some of your questions for Dr. Nair. Anuj, I want to ask her how I can become an astronaut. Sohil, I want to know why other planets have many moons and we have just one. Natasha, I will ask her about what I must study to become a space scientist. Sarah, here comes our principal with Dr. Nair. The students stand up to greet the principal and Dr. Nair. They have a lovely interactive session with her. Here is a summary for lesson 4, Reaching for the Moon. This play is set in a classroom. The students of class 6C are waiting for Dr. Nair, who was part of India's space program on Chandrayaan 2. The students are extremely excited and are asking many questions about space to their science teacher, Mrs. Asha Vakil. She is patiently answering all their questions. In a series of questions and answers between the students and the teachers, the students learn the difference between a space scientist and an astronaut and the names of the first Indian scientists who worked on questions related to space. They also discuss some of the characteristics of the moon, like its gravity, how it causes tides, its atmosphere, and so on. The class discusses the importance of developing space program and sending satellite into space. They also talk about the astronaut of Indian origin who have been into space. Furthermore, Mrs. Vakil tells the students the aim behind launching Chandrayaan 1 and Chandrayaan 2. Mrs. Vakil tells the student to save some of their questions for Dr. Nair. The play concludes with the principal of the school and Dr. Nair's entering the classroom. By this, we finish today's session. Thank you.